Hello friends, welcome to Cook With Us. Today we are making Danish pastries. So let's see how to make it. We have taken 250 grams of soft flour. Now I'll add salt in it. Now we'll mix the salt with the use of our hands. Now to make our dough from the flour, we'll make a yeast solution. So for the solution, I'm taking about 50% of moisture. Now we'll add sugar in it. So we will put 2 tablespoons of sugar. 1, and there goes 2. Now we will add yeast in the solution. You can see sticky yeast, which will ferment our dough and make nice Danish pastries. I'll add a bit more. Now we'll whisk the yeast and water and sugar, obviously, to make it a solution. You don't have to whisk it very vigorously, but the speed is such that sugar should dissolve in water. Now I guess the sugar has dissolved in the water and I'm getting a foul smell, obviously because of yeast. Now we'll make the dough. So we have made a well in our flour and we'll add the solution in this well. And gradually make it to a soft dough. It's very sticky. What is, I guess? It will take time to make a dough, but once the final result is ready, it will be very fruitful. Now we'll add a bit more water to make it soft. Water, I mean solution we have left with. This is very beneficial when you're making a dough, especially a bread dough made of yeast scraper. This can be used as your left hand. Normally egg is also used while making Danish pastries, but I am making a veg version, so I've skipped it, and instead of egg I have increased the percent of moisture. So as I had told earlier that we'll use 50% of moisture, I have used 60% of it. And now you can see we have got a sticky result. And to make it a proper dough, I have to knead it for at least 5 minutes. Like this. So that the gluten strands develop and we can get a fluffy pastry. Now see, it's not sticking anymore. That means our gluten strands are becoming more active and longer. So this is the time we'll add shortening in it. Shortening in the form of fat, obviously. So here goes 2/3 tablespoon of oil. That equals 10 ml. Yes, that's too much of oil. And I have to make a dough with this. Now, if you wish, you can add a bit of flour in it so that it does not stick. But I won't prefer it because that will somehow not develop the perfect bread you want. Now our dough is ready. See, it's not sticking anymore. We'll make a ball of it.
You can make a oval also.
That's looking good. Now we'll rest it for 10 minutes, covering it obviously. Now it's time for adding layers in our dough. For that, first we'll roll this into square. But since we can see it sticking over here, we'll apply a layer of dusting. Thin layer of dusting. To not roll it very into a very thin sheet, it will have a thickness. To some extent, we can say that it's in square, it's a square. So now we'll add fat. Or apply fat on this. Now I've kept a block of butter on the dough diagonal, you can see. Now clearly see the steps how to make it. First you have to stretch this part, now this part, and similarly we'll stretch these parts. So all the four sides we are stretching. With the help of fingertips. Now we will overlap the sides over the butter. See, like this, we have covered the whole butter from one side. Now this one, yes, we have again overlapped the butter. Like this. And like this. You have to overlap the butter all the four times. And we have made a dough. Now see, what's it? Over here we have dough, over here dough, and at middle we have fat content, which is butter. You can use margarine also, but make sure it's puff margarine. Now it's winter time over here, that's why I can roll it and keep for some while. But if it's summer there, then you have to keep it in refrigerator after each and every step. Now carefully observe the steps of rolling it. As we know, butter is here, so we have to press it in such a manner that butter spreads equally. We can see butter is quite harder. So what I will do is gently press it to melt the butter. Now see how to fold this. We have made a rectangular sheet. Thickness is about 1/2 inch. First, we'll do like this. Press the center. So we have got a line over here. Now one fold like this. And one fold from this side like this. Keep distance between two layers. Don't stick both of them. And now overlap one on another. So this is our one fold. We have to do 5 folds like this. To make our Danish pastries. From our laminated dough, I have made these shapes and had kept them for proofing for 1.5 hours. Now they have doubled. In these, I have 3 with fillings. You can see. This is a simple wedge filling made of cottage cheese and potatoes, and rest of them don't have any filling. Now is the time to bake them. We will bake them for 15 minutes under 210 degrees Celsius. Now let's see our result. So my oven is preheated. Now I'll keep the rolls in the middle rack. We have not applied egg wash or milk anything since it has a lot of fat content. Either we have not greased the trays or tray. So 15 minutes. Yes. So 15 minutes are over now. Our product has been baked. Now let's see how it's done. Looks good. You can see the color on top. See how beautifully they have been baked. They look really good. See the layers. Flaky from outside, soft from inside. Our Danish pastry is ready. Do comment if you liked the video. Bye for now.